What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video, next match, Cross Balanced Cup, and this is like a huge one, if not I feel the best one, I think yet, at least from this year, you know, this year's Cross Balanced Cup. Anyway, two titans are paired up against each other, as you already know, the first one, you have Zoodiex, doesn't need an introduction, right? Second list, well, pure Zeus, by the way. The second list, we have Monarchs, extra deck Monarchs, again, a very strong list. Again, quite honest here is that if I would set that, you know, if there's like one deck, or maybe there are like a couple of decks that can at least definitely have a chance against something like Zoodiex, and Monarchs, extra deck Monarchs is definitely one of those, a very high ceiling, a very powerful deck, but, you know, has like that, or at least those weaknesses, very vulnerable to its normal summon. And of course, the high brick chance. So, it's quite iffy. So yeah, which deck has the advantage? And I quite agree that Zoodiex might have, you know, like the advantage here. Especially in this particular matchup. But again, as I mentioned before, the high ceiling of extra deck Monarchs, the power plays. Well, Stormfort is still very strong, right, to disrupt the boards of Zoodiex. So, for me, it was like 55 against like 45, something like that. But okay, it's going to be a good one. So sadly, Monarchs going second, since again, Monarchs definitely want to go first. The huge problem here is that, okay, Zoodiex do have like, you know, the, of course, the five draws, but the multiple hand traps and mainly the triple Ash Blossom, very strong against Monarchs. No Pantheism, no Idea Summon, well, Idea Effect, I guess, to special summon something from the deck. A Ghost Ogre is also okay against Monarchs, and Maxi is quite decent as well. So, yeah, Zoodiex definitely has like the advantage with the hand traps, that is. So going second, and I definitely needed the Pantheism 2 draws, right? Again, getting those extra 2 draws, potentially drawing, well, let's say Twin Twister maybe, or Stormfort, Erebus or something like that. That would have been very sweet, but oh, this is so terrible. Again, like, getting the extra 2 draws didn't really help too much. I think I already used up a Stormfort during this particular turn, so no, I can't use Brilliant Fusion, and I'm not really sure if I have Prime? Do I have Prime in the graveyard? But again, it's not going to matter too much. I mean, if you're giving Zoodiex another turn, I mean, during their first turn, they will get a couple of pluses, but during their second turn, like, best case scenario for them is like turn number 3, they'll gain more pluses like an Emerald or whatever, right, through the Zoodiex engine. The deck on itself is quite crazy, and it can definitely OTK through 8k damage and even through a Prime, so that's definitely a problem. Game number 2, Monarchs getting to start, and this is an okay opening hand, although kinda banking on the 2 extra draws off of Prime, but it all works out fine, even though Kuras isn't really the best. Well, it's fine, I guess, it's better than, you know, like the first turn Majesty's Fiend, but, well, then again, Majesty's Fiend against something like Zoodiex is, of course, very strong. But the Dark Hole is quite of a bummer. As you know, Zoodiex is running double Dark Hole and one Raigeki, so those Moss board wipes is definitely like strong, especially against Monarchs, forcing out a potential 8th here. Eventually going for Kuras, again getting the extra draw, but most importantly making the Brilliant Fusion life and the Instant Fusion as well. Well, Brilliant Fusion, Lazuli, right? Like, there is only one Brilliant Fusion target here in the main deck, being the Lazuli. So again, that's a bummer. Tornado Dragon kind of feels like an underdog deck against extra deck Monarch, well, underdog card against extra deck Monarchs, like popping Return or threatening the Brilliant Fusion or the Return or Domain. So Tornado Dragon is definitely an underdog against this deck. Did not use the Prime earlier, don't want to risk, you know, like Trident attacking into the defense position Prime, and then, you know, thanks to Viper banishing the Prime as well. So I definitely needed the extra level 4, level 5, and yeah, to force out the Trident. And now, first go for the extra deck summon, and then use the Idea Eidos combination, using like one of the graveyard effects, you know, which one I mean, and going for the double tribute summon, double Aether indeed, and dropping the Majesty's Fiend, and this should be like my game already. Then again, there are of course, well, with the barrage still on the field, there is of course a slight chance that he has like a powerful enough monster on the field to first of all, well, just attack over Majesty's Fiend. But then again, there is still the Stormfort Aether play live, so this again should be my duel. He again has like the priority to use his first effect during his main phase too, but you know, like, I don't want to let him go for something like Trident. So definitely go for the Stormfort Aether play, get Erebus, and finally a breakthrough, I guess. So going for Tyras, not going to matter too much. Any extra deck monster would have done it, right? So game number 3, Zuliex opening up with Desires feels weak, I guess. I mean, it's not really optimal using Desires or right from the start. You don't want to lose like a Mon or you don't want to lose your Red Pier from your main deck, right? Like banishing one of, at least one of them being like banished from the Pot of Desires. Anyway, so his opening turn is very strong. Again, the Tornado Dragon threatening the Brilliant Fusion, threatening a possible domain. I kind of sometimes need domain for the one-off tribute summon or return as well. So Tornado Dragon is definitely very strong, and Dagusta Emerald getting the extra draws, kind of increasing the chances of opening, you know, like drawing into hand traps. Again, the Ash Blossom, so okay, that's fine. Another Prime getting those extra two draws, but sadly no tribute. Well, good tribute, I guess. And I was like, well, let's force out the Tornado Dragon, I think. Tornado Dragon was still alive, or yeah, indeed, the Tornado Dragon, because I needed to return, right? To return to get an extra Surge Aether, but in the long run, it's not going to matter too much. Again, give Zuliex one monster, they can definitely come back, but if you're giving them two monsters, that's a huge problem. Just using like a Shekinine, you know, like getting those mass pluses, especially with Barrage on Ram, it feels always well. My hand on the other side wasn't that great, but it's again very lackluster. So some shenanigans, I believe. Double Drydent, I guess. Yeah, Double Drydent is cute. I think that's pretty much it. Shekinine with the massive attack boost, eventually also banishing the Prime as well. Not really sure if I have another copy of Prime in the graveyard. Indeed. Okay, that's fine, but whatever. Double Drydent is going to pop at least two cards, and I needed at least another Stormfort, in the long run, it's not going to matter. Well, maybe with Stormfort getting rid of one of the Drydents and then return searching something like Aether, that definitely could have been okay, but that's not the case. So we're going into a game number 4, and dude, this one is a huge one. So Monarch's going first, and this is a bonkers opening hand. But then again, vulnerable to a well-timed Ash Blossom, and okay, Ghost Ogre might could cause some pain, but no hand. Oh yeah, well, no, like Ash Blossom, right? So that's good. And drawing into Instant Fusion, so fantastic. Going for the rank 5 exceed play. Going for Pleiades. Durandal was also in the back of my mind, but I was like, well, let's go for Pleiades threatening, the normal summon, the crucial normal summon during the opponent's turn, or potentially bounce back something from my side of the field, just in case, like, again, those Darkholes or Raigeki. So again, going for Titanic Galaxy against the Moss board wipes, double Darkhole, Raigeki, and triple Zuliex Barrage, especially with, you know, the normal summon being so crucial here in this position, the Pleiades bouncing back any normal summoned monster on the opponent's side of the field, and again, Titanic Galaxy being there to prevent the barrage from activating, right, if there would have been a barrage. So going for the rank 5 exceed play, and this is more than enough to attack for a game. So a fifth gamer is coming, and Monarch is going second, and I see my opening hand, and I was like, okay, this could be bad or this could be good. So Maxi is definitely good, trying to get some extra draws, but only like a 1-for-1, and sadly no like Erebus or Pantheism, and seeing how average the Zuliex opening hand was, like only one interruption, I think, with the Drydent, and Dimensional Barrier is okay. I mean, okay, Dimensional Barrier for Fusion or whatever, or maybe Exceed, that's whatever, but especially if I would have had like a Pantheism, Tenacity for Pantheism, some extra draws, a Monarch summon, then there was definitely a good game or an equal game here. But now, you know, triple Brilliant Fusion, and I already in this position, I'm so far behind, and I'm not really sure if there's a potential threat to go for game. Prime is still in the graveyard, or not, no, Prime is not in the graveyard, so Vipers, I think two Vipers were banished, as you saw. But yeah, again, it's not going to matter too much. Again, the Emerald will get some extra draws here. The Ghost Ogre as a potential disruption. And of course, Double Drydent. What can I do? So the second Brilliant Fusion is going to get stopped. Instant Fusion is not going to matter too much. Kuras for like one draw. But again, it's not going to matter too much. What can I top deck, right? And I believe it's a Prime. Yeah, not going to matter too much. Another Ghost Ogre. Some extra draws off of Emerald. And eventually, that should be more than enough to deck for game. So a very unfortunate game number 5. I opened well with an XC, but I needed some extra luck. Quite unfortunate that, well, those extra brilliant fusions, let's say if those were Pantheism into Monarchs, well, like best case scenario, again a bunker's hand like in the previous game, then Monarchs definitely had a chance here in game number 5, but that wasn't the case, so Zoodiex will move on here to the top 4. Next matchup is already known here against ABC's, right? But again, like always, feel free to leave your prediction here for the next matchup. All the way on the left bottom, we have Atlanteans versus Infernities. So again, like always, feel free to leave your predictions. Okay, guys, that's it. Thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Lead them signing out. Peace.